Hi guys, welcome back. I'm Vivek Singhal from tradingwithvivek.com, and today we are going to discuss in this scenario where there is a bear market, and due to this COVID-19 pandemic, the market was crashed and there is a lot of uncertainty that which sector will do good and which sector will do bad. So what to buy, what not to buy, which company is going to have a bad effect and which company is going to flaunt in this kind of uncertainty. So we need to discuss that what are those companies those are going to take charge in this rally. Yeah, in this rally I mean in this rally from the bottom to the top, whether this rally is going to sustain over a period of time or it is going to go down again after making an intermediate high. So it is very difficult to understand based on the businesses, because we do have a very less understanding of what is going to happen and how far this pandemic is going to last. See, there are uncertainties over the upcoming vaccines. Those are being developed by different scientists and doctors across the world in all other countries, including India. So it's a big question what to buy and how to structure our portfolio. What are those companies? Those can give us a decent return over a period of next 12 months period. So before moving ahead, there is a small disclaimer again that this is an educational video, and whatever we are going to discuss is based on the understanding of last bear market, which had happened in 2008 during financial crash. And my whole purpose is to make myself and you understand that how can we take a decent prudent decisions in such kind of uncertain market. And further, before moving ahead, if you yet not have subscribed my channel, please do subscribe, and I will keep on making this kind of videos to improve our trading skills. So let's start. See, what we have seen, what I have observed during this kind of uncertain market, when there is a bear market. So bear market is always followed by a bull market, and bear market does not last forever. It may last for a week, it may last for a month or 6 months or a year or maybe a few years sometimes if the situation is worse. But having a look at the performance of Nifty and Bank Nifty and all other indices and Nasdaq and Dow Jones, it looks like that something is going to happen, good on the front of these vaccines development, because that's why the Nasdaq has been able to went through the all-time high level. And all-time high in itself is a great achievement, because at that level there is no one in loss other than those who had short the market. Otherwise, who are investors and traders, those take position only on the long side, all are in benefit. So I had done some in-depth analysis that what had happened during the last 2008 crash, and I found out that the companies, those were the front runners in hitting all-time high, were the companies those had given a decent return over the period of next 12 months from the month in which they had hit the all-time high. For example, that time when Hindustan Unilever had hit the all-time high, or TCS, or Hero Motor Corp, or any other company. So now here, when we are in uncertain period, so fundamentally it is very difficult to take a decision that which company is going to have a bad impact and which company is going to prosper. Because one more thing I would like to tell you, that we are talking about the trading, and trading's related decisions are mostly taken based on the chart patterns and not on the basis of the balance sheet or on the business prospects. But the company should be a bigger one, so that there could be bigger liquidity, means a higher liquidity. And one more thing, the big guys, those are operators in the market, they do always try to they do always try to invest in big companies because they are having big pockets, and that kind of big money can only be traded because the market capitalization of those companies are bigger, so they can easily move in and move out a few thousand crore rupees. But in small companies, that is not practical possible. Practically, that is not possible in small companies. So let's first have a look at the Nifty 50 companies. Those were those were part of Nifty 50 during that 2008 crash. So these are those 50 companies. Those were Nifty 50, because right now Nifty 50 does not comprise all those 50 companies. Those were there in 2008, and a lot of changes have been made. A lot of new companies have came in, and a lot of companies have moved out. So if we do an analysis, so I found out that almost 15 companies out of those 50 companies have never made an all-time high since that January 2008 crash. And so it's a big thing that the company which has not made an all-time high, those have not made an all-time high after that. Means if someone was invested in those companies for last 12 years, so they are struggling to make money, and rather they have lost money because a lot of companies in these 15 companies are not part of Nifty 50 companies as of now. Even few companies, for example, Unitech and Reliance Energy and Satyam Computers, Suzlon, these companies, Arcom, these companies are penny companies now. Even Idea is also a penny company. Penny in the sense that there is a huge capital erosion, and see, this is almost 10,000 crore rupees companies now, but almost 80%, more than 80% capital has been eroded off investors. So these were 15 companies, and these three companies got merged with other companies like Cain India, RPL and Ranbaxy. So rest companies, if we talk about, these are those 10 companies. Those were first one to make all time high after January 2008 crash. So on the number one, Bajaj Auto, it made an all time high in May 2009, BPCL August 2009, Dr. Reddy September 2009, Galaxo August 2009, Hero MotoCorp April 2008, Infosys September 2009, ITC July 2009, Maruti July 2009, PNB May 2009, NSBI October 2009. So these were the first 10 companies out of 50 companies of that time. Those were part of Nifty 50 to make all-time high. And had we invested 10% in each these companies as and when they were hitting all-time high, and we had kept these companies, we were remain invested for just for 12 months after the investment, or after taking the long trade. So they were a huge return we could have got. If for example, not for example, if we have a look at the performance of these 10 companies, those were the first runner to make all-time high. I'm saying all-time high, whether that all-time high was just in January 2008, or it was in 2006, or in case of IT companies or in any other company, if it were before that, even few companies all-time high was in 2000 at the time of IT boom. So when these companies hit all-time high and we made a long position, 10% each in each stock, then Bajaj Auto, if we had invested in May 2009 when it had hit the all-time high, and if we get out in May 2010, it had given us a return of 150% gain. It's a huge return. Then BPCL 51%, Dr. Reddy 66%, Glaxo 34%, and Hero Honda 49%, Infosys 29%, ITC 30%, Maruti 15%, PNB 59%, and SBI 36%. And if I do the average of these 10 companies' returns, this is 52% on an average return. It's amazing, you know, when such a uncertainty is there in the market, and we are very much unable to find out that which company is going to sustain. Even there is a question of survival, and if we do take just our decision based on the price action, that what is happening there, if a company is making all-time high in such a bear market scenario, it means the smart money is chasing those stocks, and smart money means the smartest guy on the street. And if we do follow their path, then it's a certain path of success in the trading we can see here. So having a look at 2008 market crash scenario and the performance of the front runner 10 companies, those were the first one to make all-time high. If we do repeat the same thing here in 2020, and if we have a look at that these Nifty out of 50 companies, how many companies have hit the all-time high? So these are 8 companies. Those have already hit the all-time high after this crash in the month of Feb and March. And first one was Hindustan Unilever to hit the all-time high 31st March 2020. Nestle 7th April 20, Bharti Airtel 13th May 20, Britannia 3rd June 20, Reliance 5th June 20, TCS 7th July 20, and HCL 15th July 20, and Infosys again 15th July 20. So all these companies are great companies. Hindustan Unilever, Nestle, Bharti Airtel, Britannia, Reliance, TCS, HCL, Infy. So either these companies are tech companies or FMCG companies, and we can understand that because market's money remain in the market and it doesn't go away, because market intermediaries would not allow to get the money out of this stock market to real estate or in the precious metal. Otherwise, what would they do here? Means money is always get shifted from one company to another company and from one industry to another industry. So if we do invest 10% each in these stocks and keep rest 20% idle and wait for two more companies to hit the all-time high and invest 10% in both those companies also and remain invested for 12 months. So it's a very, very decent, one-time call to have a portfolio for next 12 months. And because history do repeat almost always, so we can have a very decent return once again based on the history. And but one more thing, that history means past performance doesn't guarantee any the same return in future prospect. Human behavior remains same, and it's not only about human behavior. It's about where the money is going to be made. See, these companies would be fundamentally also FMCG and ID companies would be doing better than all other companies, having a look at the current market scenario and economic meltdown. Everything is locked down, so nobody is cut down their foods, and every business is being run on IT. Their business have not suffered as much as other businesses. So it's not a buy or sell recommendation. I have tried to correlate few things based on the crash of two times, and if we do understand these things, then it becomes very easy. My sole motto to make this video is to make ourselves understand that where and on which basis in such kind of an uncertain scenario, how we can take a good decision and what this pattern says. So this was for the day, and I am Vivek Singhal, and if you have not yet subscribed, then subscribe the channel. keep on watching, keep on reading a lot and watching, a lot where there is a knowledge in between. Almost always you should try to watch the complete video, because we don't know that at what particular point of time a very good point in will come in which will boost our trading skills. So this was for the day. Have a good day. Have a great day. I am Vivek Singhal from tradingwithvivek.com.